I'm Selma Teacher 7, also known as Mr. Barry, by my students. And today is day number 14. We're going to be going over using the Chrome OS found on Chromebooks, Chromeboxes, Chromebases, and other Google Chrome devices. Well, let's get started with the lesson.
The first topic is, what is a Chromebook? A Chromebook is a laptop that runs Google's Chrome operating system, also known as the Chrome OS. It offers a very similar experience as using the popular Chrome web browser, which you might well already be using on a Windows PC or a laptop, but with a few extra features added to the mix. An internet connection is central to how a Chromebook functions. Many of its apps and services are online and don't run locally. There are now many exceptions to this, with Google's own document and spreadsheet apps capable of working offline and then seamlessly syncing any work you've done to the cloud once you're back on Wi-Fi. There are also many games and other apps that are now offline capable, which can be found at the Google Web Store. This simplicity allows Chromebooks to use less powerful hardware than many Windows laptops, without it affecting the overall performance. You won't find large hard drives on Chromebooks. Instead, Google offers 100 gigabytes of online storage with every machine, which seems like a small amount, but the Google documents, spreadsheets, presentations never count against your storage. Plus, Google Photos is free with unlimited space for your high quality videos and pictures. So these machines come with very fast but small solid state drives. There are many similarities across the available models, with a generally standard Chrome OS keyboard layout and screen resolution, and fast boot up times. But those with specific needs should still be able to find a machine to suit them. For example, those looking for touchscreens or larger screens can find them. Also, there are now Chromebooks with faster processors for those who need more power. The next topic is Chrome OS laptops based on size class. In general, all Chromebooks run the Chrome OS on fast solid-state drives. They have a HD webcam, have no optical drives, and connect to the user's Google account to run applications. The smallest are the 10-inch flips. A flip Chromebook has a keyboard base that can be flipped around so that the Chromebook may be used as a tablet. One example is the ASUS Flip C100PA with the Rocket Chip ARM CPU. 2 gigs of RAM goes for around $200. These come with a 10.1-inch touchscreen. Next is the 12-inch Flip. Like the 10-inch version, the 12-inch Flip Chromebook has a keyboard base that can be flipped around too. One example is the Samsung Chromebook Plus with a hexa-core ARM CPU, 4 gigs of RAM, and runs around $450. This one has a 12.3-inch touchscreen. Then we have the 13.3-inch. Having a larger 13-inch screen size makes reading email and watching videos easier. One example is the Lenovo ThinkPad 13 with a Celeron CPU, 4 gigs of RAM. They run around $180. This one has the 13.3-inch non-touch screen. For the 14-inch class, the 14-inch Chromebook offers more of a laptop feel with more space for a roomier keyboard. Good example would be the HP Chromebook 14 that has a Celeron CPU, 4 gigs of RAM, runs around $250. This has a 14-inch non-touchscreen. For the largest class that we have to date, it's 15.6 inches. The 15.6-inch Acer Chromebook is the Goliath of Chromebooks, with the largest screen to date found on these speedy devices. Good example would be the Acer Chromebook 15 with the Intel Core i3 CPU, 4 gigs of RAM, runs around $420. This has a 15.6-inch non-touch screen. As you can see, not all Chromebooks are created equal. There are small, lightweight machines that have screen sizes of just 11.6 inches and other units that weigh in as three times as much. The 11.6 inch Chromebooks, these are the most portable Chromebooks out there. Their slim design and lightweight make them perfect for travelers, small and light enough to fit into the smallest travel backpack. You download your trip photos from your comfort of your hotel room. 13-inch Chromebooks, these have the portability of the 11-inch, but with the bigger screens and keyboards, make them much more useful when you need to do more typing. Great for business or for bloggers or travelers, these lightweight notebooks will make sure that you have your office wherever you are. 14-inch Chromebooks. These Chromebooks are perfect for those who wish to do a great deal of typing, watching of videos, and do it on a machine where you have more space on the screen. These are heavier than the lightweight 11.6 and 13-inch units, but for some, it may be well worth it. 15.6-inch Chromebooks. These are the largest of the Chromebooks, and their larger screens make video watching or extended computer working much more comfortable. With slightly more meat to them, they give you more options for travel, business, and home use. Now let's look at desktop Chrome devices. These devices are called Chrome stands by some PC makers and Chrome bases by others. Using a Chrome device. Whether you own a Chromebox, Chromebook, Chrome stick, or a Chrome stand, they make for an incredibly useful, handy machine that can turn on instantly, check your email, update your Facebook, create documents, spreadsheets, watch streaming television videos, and so much more. These beasties love running on the internet, so having fast, cheap internet is quite important. They can be running offline too, with the many offline apps now available on the Chrome Web Store, and they sync all of your data once they're back online. There are a rare breed of these machines that come with their own internet too. These are called 4G machines and receive internet the same way as your cell phones receive internet. Turning on and logging into your Chromebook is easy. This is done by opening the Chromebook and simply keying in your Gmail or your Google account information into the spaces provided. Once at the desktop, you will see the app launcher in the lower left-hand side of the screen. The bottom of the desktop is called the shelf. It is the place to pin the apps that you use the most, as you see here in this diagram. Apps may be pinned to the shelf by right-clicking on any icon of an app and selecting Pin to Shelf, as seen here. So I right-clicked here, and then you click on Pin to Shelf. Please note, on Chromebooks, a right-click is done by pressing both fingers down on the touchpad simultaneously. Apps and data are now stored within your Google account and Chromebook. So if your Chromebook is lost or stolen, none of your data or apps are lost. Just go to another Chromebook or PC, log into your Google account, and there are your apps and data. It is all protected with your password, so only you can see your work. To find the apps that are installed on your Google account, click on the app launcher. It looks like a plain circle on the shelf. Once you have clicked on the app launcher, a new window will open on your screen showing you many apps. Click on the All Apps icon to see more. To install more apps within your Google account, find and click on the Web Store icon that looks like this. Once you click on the Web Store icon, it will open up. There are many ways to search for apps here. If you know the name of an app, you may key it within the text box that says Search by Name. One popular app is Microsoft's Office. To find it, just key in the name Office without the quotation marks, and then hit the Enter key. To add any app, just click on the Add to Chrome button that appears here. Once you have installed the apps that you like, you may launch any of them by finding them within the app launcher. The next topic, the Chrome OS keyboard. Getting to know the keyboard on a Chromebook. The design of your Chromebook is a little different from traditional notebooks. The first difference that you will notice are the function keys on the top, which serve as shortcuts to common tasks. The first key is the Escape key. Escape will interrupt or cancel the current process or running program, or to close a pop-up window. The arrow keys will allow you to go back and forth to previously visited web pages. The refresh key will refresh the web page being viewed. This key will enter and exit full screen mode. This key shows all windows in overview mode. These keys dim or brighten the display. These keys control the volume settings for the speakers, where you have mute, volume down, and volume up. This is the power button. Some Chromebooks do not have a caps lock key, and instead of function keys, you have dedicated keys for managing your Chrome browser. Getting used to this may take a little while, but once you know your way around, I am sure you will enjoy it. Let's learn the keyboard shortcuts with this little trick. On any Chromebook, press Ctrl-Alt and the question mark to see an online keyboard with all of the keyboard shortcuts. So once you see the keyboard on the screen, you can press the Ctrl or Shift keys to see the shortcuts that go with those keys. Try pressing other keys to see what they do. The on-screen keyboard will let you know of all of their special functions. When you need the caps locked on, just use the following keyboard shortcut: Alt and Search. When the caps lock is turned on, you will see an up arrow icon next to the time on the taskbar. Next topic, how to set up a new Chromebook. Setting up a new Chromebook is much easier than setting up a Windows PC. Chromebooks don't require major updates or antivirus software. You start simply by signing into your Google account or creating that account if you don't already have one. Here's everything you need to know how to set up your new Chromebook up the right way, starting with the tools that let you replace the Windows software that make a Google Chromebook, very useful. Chromebooks thrive on the web and they survive offline just fine. Yes, Chromebooks are primarily conduits to the web, but you can find many apps that now run offline. These apps include all of the important Google Drive, Google Docs, Sheets, and Slides. To make sure that Google Docs, Sheets, and Slides will work offline, you may check the offline option found within the settings of your Google Drive app. Adobe has a Chrome-friendly version for Photoshop, while Microsoft offers Skype, which works well on a Chromebook. Google Hangouts is a Chromebook's default app for making free phone calls and video calls. The absolutely free Microsoft Office Online works with traditional Office docs and offers enough features for mainstream users. There are now many fun and interactive games that work offline too, such as mini versions of Solitaire. More ways for preparing your Chromebook for offline use. Beyond offline Chrome apps, numerous native Chromebook apps and features can be configured for use away from the web. For example, Google's Gmail Offline lets you work with Gmail while offline. Download the app from the Chrome Web Store, then fire it up from the Chrome OS App Launcher. You'll then be asked if you want to save your messages offline. If you sign into multiple Google accounts, toggle the email address at the bottom to select where to save your email data. Once enabled, Gmail Offline lets you reply and compose new messages, which are then cached and fired off to the recipient once you are back online. Next topic, Chrome updates. Normally, your Chromebook updates itself automatically as new updates roll out. To see your Chromebook Chrome OS version, just key in chrome:// chrome in the address box found within the browser. A new window should open. Click on Check for and Apply Updates. The most recent version is version 56 as of March 2017. If you see an arrow pointing up at the bottom right of your screen, it means that there is a Chrome update and that needs to be added. Just click it and then click Restart to install the update. The Chromebook should restart in seconds. Next topic. Set up your Chromebook for printing. Now, I highly recommend watching my videos on setting up printers with your Google account. In this short segment, I will go over how to set up printing from a Chromebook. First off, you do not plug your printer into your Chromebook as you would in the past. The printer is plugged either into a Windows PC or your router. Google Cloud Print Ready printers connect directly to your Wi-Fi router wirelessly, so the printer is connected to the internet and to your Google account, as seen here in my diagram. So this is option one, use a Google Cloud Ready printer. Here's your Google account, where you find your apps, your data, all of your devices, and your printers. Here you are at your Chromebook. You'd hit the shortcut Control P. It goes up to your router, goes into your Google account, sees your printers, and then sends the print job to the printer that you own and have registered to your Google account. So printers are added or registered to your Google account, freeing you from having to install printer drivers as was done in the past. Google Cloud Ready printers are now easy to find at Walmart and other retailers. Just set it up with your Wi-Fi router by following the instructions that came with your printer. Then register the printer to your Google account by following those steps found in the printer's manual or by calling your printer's support phone number and having them set it up for you. This is free, and the printer's manufacturer's tech support do a great job doing this for you. Just make sure that you call only your printer's support phone number. Here are a few numbers. If it's Samsung printer help, it's 1-800-726-7864. HP printer help is 1-800-474-6836. And Canon printer help is 1-800-652-2666. Option 2 would be to use your Windows PC as a print server. Here again, you see your Google account that has your apps, your data, your devices, and your printers. But this time, you have an older printer that is not connected directly to your router, but instead is connected to a Windows PC. Here you are on your Chromebook. Again, you hit the shortcut Control P, or you click on the print icon. It sends the print job up through the router and into your Google account, which then sees your printers, comes down, goes through this Windows PC, which is still logged into your Google account, and then sends it out to the printer. An easy way to add a classic or non-Google Cloud Ready printer to your Google account is to go to a Windows PC that is connected to your printer. Once there, log into your Google account and any pictures or printers that are connected to that Windows PC are automatically added to your Google account instantly. You may then print to that printer with your Chromebook as long as that Windows PC and printer are on and logged into your Google account. This is because you are using that Windows PC as a type of print server that allows access to that printer as long as it is logged into your account. Now, you may have multiple Google accounts on a Windows PC, and they may all be logged in simultaneously if you wish. To see whether your Chromebook recognizes your printer, simply open the Chrome settings menu, that is, click on the icon that looks like three dots at the top right corner of the browser window. Then select Settings. Key in Google Cloud Print into the settings search box, and that option will show up. Click on the Manage button. Under the New Devices, you should see the name of your printer, assuming it's properly connected to your network, as seen here. So this is a screenshot from my Chromebook, and it shows my Samsung printer right here. Google Cloud Print connects your Chromebook to a compatible printer. If your printer doesn't show up in the list, it may not be a Google Cloud Print ready, or it could be having some other connection issue. You may have to dig out the instruction manual or head to the printer's specific help page. Google also has a support site that may point you to the right direction. If your printer isn't Cloud Print enabled, the only way to print stuff from your Chromebook is to use option 2 and connect your printer to a Mac or a Windows PC. Log into your Google account on that specific machine and then use your Mac or PC as a type of print server. The print server option works well enough, but if you plan to print a great deal from your Chromebook, you will want to spring for a Google Cloud Print Ready printer. Another advantage of Google Cloud Print is that once it's configured, you can print from any device that you can sign in to your Google account, such as your smartphone or tablet. Here is a Canon PIXMA MX490, which is Google Cloud Print Ready and only $40 at Walmart. Be Chromebook power user. I use my Chromebook for everything from creating my lessons, books, videos, to watching movies and playing games. You can too. The beauty of Chromebooks is that after the initial setup, most people will never need to worry about troubleshooting or any other kind of maintenance, updating, or management. Those things are all done automatically for you. Next topic. Now let's go on and see how to use these machines as entertainment centers. Many people take their Chrome devices and hook them up with their big screens via an HDMI cable and watch streaming videos, movies, and even TV shows. There are many apps for playing MP4 and AVI videos that are downloaded on external drives. To find the millions of free apps available on the Google Web Store, do these steps. Step number one, within a Chromebook, click on the App Launcher found in the lower left portion of your desktop screen. The app menu should load as seen here. Find the Web Store icon. If you do not see it on the front page, click on the All Apps icon to find it there. Once you click on the Web Store icon, the Chrome Web Store should open as seen here. The Chrome Web Store is the one place to find millions of apps. These apps are sorted by category and type. You can type the words movie player into the search box and hit the enter key once. Another option is to find AVI players. To find those, you key in AVI player into the search box and then hit the enter key once. You may add both types of apps this way. You will see some movie playing apps pop up. You may need to scroll down the list until you find the apps that you want. To add any of these, simply click on the blue button that reads Add to Chrome, and then the Confirm window will ask you, are you sure? Simply click Add to finish the install. After adding these, you should be able to play any AVI or MP4 movies that you have. You may also add the app called Pluto to watch live TV right over the internet. Next topic. Do you wish to find more information on all the latest Chromebooks? If you do, visit www.chromebookchart.com. Let's go to this website and see how to use it. Here at the website, you can select the specs that you want to search for, such as the RAM amount, storage, octane score, screen size, and other features. You can also look for the location, such as US, UK, Canada, and the different types of devices, such as Chromebooks, Chromeboxes, Chromebases, or Chromebits. And so if you wanted to find all of the 14 inch, you click on 14 and then it shows those here. You may then compare them on battery life, RAM amount, or solid state drive, or even by octane or the processor. That website has a great wealth of information if you wish to research Chromebooks. Now, how were the Chromebooks tested? Three benchmarking tests were used. You have SunSpider, which lower scores are better, Octane, which shows higher scores are better, and then Mozilla Kraken, lower scores are better. Google's Octane is a modern benchmark that allows a JavaScript engine's performance by running a suite of tests representative of today's complex and demanding web applications. Octane's goal is to measure the performance of JavaScript code found in large real-world web applications. And here's a sample score that you would receive after running the benchmarking suite. Tips for shoppers looking for a new Chromebook. When deciding on your Chromebook, consider your intended use. For traveling, the 11.6 inch is your best option. If, on the other hand, you spend more of the day out and about with the computer or on the go and need something light and portable, then a 13 inch is for you. Do you need more substantial notebook for those projects or to stream your favorite shows? Then the 14 inch or larger is for you. Choose a Chromebook with an HDMI port that will let you connect to your HD TV or projector for that great movie experience. The good news is that all of the new Chromebooks come with HDMI ports. Chromebooks typically come with either one or up to three 3.0 USB ports, which allow you to connect your hard drive and other storage to your notebook. 3.0 ports offer the faster data transfer speeds compared to 2.0 USB ports. One little note I may add here too is when I went and looked at the newest Chromebooks, they all came with USB Type-C ports, which are the fastest to date. If you plan on running a lot of programs or apps, then the 16GB version should be just fine. On the question of RAM amount, 2 or 4 gig or above will be enough. With your new Chromebook, you will receive 16GB for you to store your files on your Google Drive locally. Most Chromebooks should come with a coupon offering additional online storage for the further 2 years. Now, just to let you know that your Google Docs, spreadsheets, presentation, your photos, and high-definition videos do not count against your storage. Before you buy your Chromebook, consider your hard disk drive storage. Because you have online storage, you do not need as much HDD space as on other laptops. They will have 64GB, 32GB, or 16GB of internal hard disk drive storage. To save money on buying more online storage, choose one of the with more space or something with an SD card slot for extra storage. If you need more power and speed, consider a Chromebook with an Intel processor paired with 4GB of RAM. If you need more battery life, consider a unit with the Intel Tegra processor or other ARM processor. Add a 3 or 4G data plan to your Chromebook purchase and you will always be online no matter where you are. Some of these notebooks have the added benefit of free 3G or 4G data connection or free GoGo in-flight internet passes. If you are going to do a lot of typing, consider both the quality and size of the keyboard. 14-inch Chromebooks such as the HP 14 or the Acer 15 have bigger, more comfortable keyboards. Your Chromebook casing will either be plastic or aluminum. Plastic cases are of great value for money and are already lower costed product, and the aluminum is durable and light. Because of their minimalistic designs, Chromebooks as a whole offer longer battery life. This is because they are designed to be on the road. Check to see that your machine's battery life meets your needs. This can vary widely from model to model, but battery life in hours is provided by the manufacturers and should be listed in most products' descriptions. Most units will go 7 hours, while others, such as some Acer 15 models, can go longer than 11 hours. Next topic. According to www.compareaboo.com, the top 10 Chromebooks are these here, and that's as of March 2017. So number one is the Acer Chromebook 15 model CB5-571. Gets a score of 9.8. And there were 752 reviews for that product. So that's the top choice, and that's the one I own. Number two is the Samsung Chromebook 3. And you see that one there. Number three is the HP Chromebook 11. It's a little tiny one there. Number four, HP Chromebook 14. Number five, the Dell Chromebook here. Number six, HP 14. Number seven, the Asus 11.6-inch Chromebook. And then number eight, the HP Chromebook 11. G4. So this one here comes with G4 here. That's kind of interesting. Number 9, the Acer Chromebook 15 CB5-571-362Q. And then number 10, the HP Chromebook 11 G3, the 11.6-inch. So, question comes up, what can I do on my Chromebook when it is offline? You can view photos, edit photos, watch movies, play music, read books, view and edit Microsoft Word documents, view and edit Microsoft Excel documents, view PDFs and ebooks, play games, and use multiple native apps. How, you ask? There are Chrome offline apps designed to work perfectly even when you are offline. Here are the top 10 Chrome apps for your Chromebook. Number one is Pocket. Pocket has a neat Chrome app that lets you read articles offline. If you are a Pocket user, there's no need of introduction here. It's the same as the Pocket experience that you get on your iOS or on your Android tablet or smartphone. Number two, Pixlr TouchUp. Smart, easy offline photo editor. Touch up, clone, crop, resize, rotate, adjust color, and add effects, and even more. Number three, Wunderlist for Chrome. Your beautiful and simple to do list app. Now as a Chrome app. Any.do, another world famous to-do list app as a Chrome app. Google Keep, the note-taking app for Google that we all have a lot of hope on. Google has an elegant Chrome app for Google Keep. Google Plus Photos. Upload and share photos from Chrome. There's a lot more expected from this app as well. Marqueed screenshots, simple screenshot sharing and discussion. Typefu. Typefu is an app that will teach you how to type very fast the right way. The Economist, free to download and includes free access to the editor's picks and selection of articles from each week's edition of The Economist. And then you have Songlist, a music player right on your Chromebook. Next topic, how do I edit Word documents when my Chromebook is offline? QuickOffice is now built into Chrome OS. That means you can edit documents offline without any plugin or extension. When you open up an MS Word file on the Chromebook, the QuickOffice app picks that up and opens up in a new tab. QuickOffice is a company product that Google acquired recently. You can also use Microsoft's OneDrive offline app, which allows you to have the Microsoft banners. Top tips for using Chrome and the Chrome browser. Number one, these tips work for both the browser and the Chrome OS. Number two, install offline apps to work offline. Three, looking for the caps lock key, press Alt and search. 4. You can configure the search key to do other things. Go to the settings page and then search for keyboard settings. On keyboard settings page, search the drop-down menu is what you're looking for. You can set it to work as you want with Alt, Control, Caps Lock, or even disable it. Number 5. For home key, press Control Alt up arrow. For N key, press Control Alt down arrow. For delete key, press Alt backspace. You can use the same keyboard shortcuts for deleting files from the File Manager and Google Drive. Number 8. To lock your Chromebook screen, press Control Shift L. Number 9. You can open apps pinned on the taskbar by using a keyboard shortcut such as Alt Number, where the number is the position of the app. For example, on the taskbar, if the first icon is always the Chrome icon, which opens in a new tab, ignore that. Assume that the second app in there is Gmail. Press Alt 1. You will see the Gmail opening in the new tab. Number 10, view the BIOS firmware version. To get the firmware of Chrome, your Chromebook, go to the Crash shell and type /sbin/chromeos-firmware-update-v/grip and then BIOS version. How to print from your Chromebook. Set up Google Cloud Printing from the settings. Set this up from the PC that you're logged in with your Google Chrome account and then connect to the printer. Number 12, how to reset your Chromebook, like a factory reset or even wipe. Go to the login screen. Press Ctrl, Alt, and R, and then click on the Reset button. The other way that you can do this is by going into Settings and then type Power Wash, spelled Power Wash, and then that will do the same thing. 13, how to diagnose Wi-Fi or a 3G connection issue on your Google Chromebook. Whenever your connection is flaky, open up Chrome:// diagnostics from the Chrome address bar or Omnibox and select the connection type, such as Wi-Fi or 3G. Chromebook will now start testing the adapter and show you the results. 14. How to download torrents on your Google Chromebook? Use the JS Torrent app. It even works offline. 15. To change window transparency on your Google Chromebook, visit chrome:// transparency. 16. Use Ctrl+Alt+Shift+Reload to make your Chromebook do a barrel roll. It's cool, and try it out. 17. To find millions of offline apps, just visit the offline apps section of the Chrome Web Store. 18. To take a screenshot, press and hold Ctrl and then tap this key found on the top of your keyboard. 19. To take a partial screenshot and by selecting the area you want to capture, press Ctrl Shift and this key. 20. If you're on a Chromebook with touchscreen, go to Settings, More Tools, Take Screenshot to take the screenshot using the touchscreen. Refresh Google Drive cache. Hold the Ctrl and press Refresh. 22. Changing your Chromebook's release channel. This is the software version. It's a good idea if you want to experiment or check out new features waiting for the general release. To change channels, visit this place, chrome:// help, and then click on More Info. You can switch channels here, and with one restart, you will be on the new release channel that you picked. 23. To insert Unicode characters, press Ctrl+Shift+U and the number of the Unicode character. 24. To clear local cache and reload the Google Drive, hold the Ctrl and then click on the Google Drive settings key on the Google Drive. You will see those additional options showing up in the settings menu. 25. To clear local cache and reload Google Drive, hold the Ctrl and then click on the Google Drive settings key on the Google Drive. And you'll show up like this. 26. To open the command prompt, press Ctrl+Alt+T. Once you're in the command prompt, type shell and hit the enter key to go to the shell prompt. 27. Once you're at the command prompt, which was Ctrl+Alt+T, you can do SSH using the following format: SSH, username and computer name or IP address. To view available SSH options, type SSH, and then hit the enter key, and then hit the enter key one more time. 28. On an ARM-based Chromebook, hold Escape Refresh buttons, then push Power to enter the developer's mode. To view hardware information of your Chromebook while it is booting, press Ctrl+I or Tab+I. To get the version of Chrome your Google Chromebook is running using the CLI in dev mode, type /opt/google/chrome/chrome-version, and that would be within the cross shell. 31. To view free space available on your Google Chromebook's local drive, like your HD or SSD, visit this site. Chrome:// quota-initials. Alternatively, you can click the gear icon on the Files app to view remaining space, which is normally the way I do it. 32. To enable accessibility options on your Google Chromebook, visit Chrome:// settings/search/accessibility. You can enable the accessibility menu, spoken feedback, and other accessibility options. 33. Enable tab dragging from setting that is an accessibility. Search tab, dragging it from the settings page. 34. Press Shift, Alt, and M to open the file manager. 35. While viewing pictures from the Chrome OS file manager, press E, as in editor, to quickly edit the picture using the built-in image editor. 36. You can create a recovery media right from your Google Chromebook. All you need is a 4 GB or larger USB flash drive or SD card. This card needs to be wiped completely, so make sure that you don't have any data on it. Open up Chrome:// image burner and follow the on-screen instructions. So what you do is you'd actually just key this into the address box. And that's how you burn an image to your flash drive. 37. To view the total amount of RAM, open Chrome:/system and then find memo or mem info and click expand. 38. To view the MAC address of your device, go to settings. Search for internet connection. Now click on the information which will be displayed. The hardware address listed there is the MAC address. 39. To know the bandwidth used by your Chromebook or Chromebox, open Chrome:/net-internals/#bandwidth. 40. Hold the Shift key and then click on any app to open it in a separate window without the address bar. This makes it look like an app instead of a website. You can right-click any app to change the way they open by default. For example, full screen, new tab, or new window, etc. 41. To change the launcher taskbar position, right-click the taskbar and then go to Launcher Position Menu. 42. Control S to save web pages for offline reading. Yes, it does work. 43. A simple method to upload music to Google Play from your Chromebook. Install and use Music Manager from the App Store. 44. Change your profile settings with the ashtray. Is a small pop-up menu you get by clicking the time and profile icon on the bottom right corner of the Chrome OS desktop. 45. See how much space you are using by right-clicking on the file manager. 46. Want HD? Go to this place, Chrome:/flags and enable force high DPI mode flag to view Google Chrome OS in high resolution. 47. If you try to open a .swf file, that's flash, from the Files app, you get an error saying it's unsupported. Drag the file to the Chrome tab and it'll work just fine there. 48. Alt-Shift-N opens the new Message Notification Center. And my favorite Chromebook, by far my favorite Chromebook, is the Acer 15, which can be found at Groupon for only $129 when I checked it today. Next topic. Ever wanted to know about your computer's hardware, BIOS, or software versions? Just type these commands within the Google Chrome browser to find more information about your computer. Chrome:/system/. That'll give you your system information. Chrome:/version/ will give you the Chrome version that you're using. Chrome:/sync-internals will give you all the internal information, such as the hard drive space and other information about your devices. Chrome:/memory-redirect will show you your memory and other information, as you see here. Now this is a scary one. Careful, these experiments may bite. Chrome:/flags/. These commands allow you to see under the hood, as it were, and take a gander at the hardware and software settings which are making your Chromebook do its work. Next topic, special Chrome OS commands that are used within the CROSH. What is the CROSH? The CROSH is the shell environment known as the Chrome shell that is provided within the Chrome OS. CROSH allows users to run several commands directly from within the Chrome OS. First off, opening CROSH. To open the CROSH, press Ctrl+Alt+T anywhere in the Chrome OS. The CROSH shell will open in a browser tab. My favorites are Top, Ping, TracePath, and SoundRecord 10, just to name a few. And here's what it looks like. Looks very much like the DOS command. Type help to see more commands. Let's go over these. SSH. Google provides an SSH client in the Chrome Web Store, but you don't need to use it. You can use the built-in SSH command to connect to SSH servers without installing anything else on your Chromebook. The SSH command is more advanced than you might expect. In addition to simply connecting to an SSH server, you can also use SSH tunneling to create a local proxy that allows you to tunnel your Chrome OS network activity over your SSH connection. You can also add private keys that may need to connect to SSH servers. SSH forgot or forget host. The SSH forget host command displays a list of known hosts that you've connected to with the SSH command and allows you to forget a host. The next time you connect to the host, you'll be asked to verify its key fingerprint again. Top. Chrome includes its own task manager that shows you which Chrome tabs, extensions, and plugins are using resources. However, CROSH also includes the top command from Linux, which gives you a display of all of the low-level processes that may be using resources. Most users will prefer using Chrome's built-in task manager, but the top utility does provide more information. It also displays some information that you can't find elsewhere within the Chrome OS, such as your Chromebook's uptime. Ping. Yes, Chrome OS also has a ping command. Ping is an important utility for network troubleshooting, allowing you to see how long packets take to travel between your system and a web server and see whether any packets are being dropped. It works just like the ping command on other operating systems. Press Ctrl+C to stop the ping process or halt any other command within the crash. Trace path. The trace path command functions similarly to trace route, allowing you to trace the path packets take to reach a remote server. It's another useful network troubleshooting command, as it allows you to determine exactly where network problems are occurring between you and another network's device. Network diag. The network diag command performs a short list of network diagnostic tests, saving the output as a TXT file that you can view in your Chromebooks Files app. Sound. Chrome includes a command that can record audio from your Chromebook's microphone and play it back later. To record 10 seconds of audio from your Chromebook's microphone, run the following command. Sound record 10. The audio will be saved as a file that you can access from your Chromebook's file app. You can also play it back with the sound play command. TP control. The TP control command allows you to fine-tune your device's touchpad. Some of these options are available in Chrome OS's settings window, but you can tweak many properties that aren't available from the graphical interface. XSetM. The XSetM command allows you to tweak your mouse acceleration rate. Chrome OS only has options for controlling the mouse's speed in its graphical interface, so any fine-tuning of the acceleration rate, particularly useful if you're using an external mouse that doesn't work well with the default rates, must be done from here. The acceleration rate is configured in the same way as you use the XSetM command to configure acceleration rates on a standard Linux system. XSetR. The XSetR command allows you to tweak the auto repeat behavior for when you hold a keyboard button down. You can select a delay before auto repeat starts and configure how many repeats occur per second. You can also disable auto repeat completely for every key on the keyboard, or just disable auto repeat for specific keys. In conclusion, I totally enjoy using my Chromebook for all of my computing chores. I hope that this lesson has helped you to better understand the vast world of Chrome OS computers. Please click thumbs up on the video and have a great day. Bye-bye.